السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I'm Abdullah Leonard. I embraced Islam 3 years ago. Before Islam, I was a Catholic. It comes from a Christian denomination. And I was born in Sri Lanka. I was brought up as a Catholic. I was living my youth, my teenage years, and all my past in as a Catholic in Sri Lanka. While I was there in the hospital, I met a brother came there. He also was as a patient. And then I met him, we had a chat with him, alhamdulillah, and he told that he was a Muslim. Okay, I said, okay. In my past, I had some knowledge about Islam, a bit ignorant. I was pretty, to be honest, I was ignorant. I didn't know much about Islam. I just thought there was something who trying to do something bad to this world, something they have a hidden agenda to destroy this world and to get precedence and get famous or something like that. And I thought that they are subjugating women and all this stuff. So I was always having a negative aspect of Islam. So once I met this brother, I said, okay, how are you? You're right. And we were having a chat. And then eventually that brother came to me one day and he said, do you want to pray with me? Do you want to pray next to me? I had questions. I didn't want to start, but I said, I stepped back and I saw him daily praying. I didn't know it's 5 times, but he was praying. And I joined him. I didn't have not much to do, so I just joined him. And I was praying with him then, alhamdulillah. So I was, he didn't give any dawah, he didn't give any introduction about Islam or whatever. I already had a perception of Islam, which is a bit negative. And all I did, I was praying with him. I know that it's the prayer of Muslims, and alhamdulillah, I was daily I was involved. The brother was so much dedicated. He really wanted to make me to. He was introduce Islam, but his method was to give the one of the commandments of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala is the salah, to involve me in the salah. So I was praying, and I got. Out of all this depression, anxiety, and all this mood disorder I had, once I was praying, I found some sort of tranquility. I didn't know even what are the meanings of the Al-Fatiha, what is has to be recited, how are the principles, how are the units have been made in the salah. But I just prayed with him. I said, follow me, just follow what I do. When I bow, just bow. When I prostrate, then prostrate. So I was following him, and I got tranquility, peace, alhamdulillah, harmony. I felt some sort of harmony when I pray. And I really had some sort of a touch with that salah. Alhamdulillah, I felt some sort of a love with the salah. And I used to call the brother. And I used to say, shall we pray? He said, okay. Oh, I didn't pray. Let's go and pray. So I was involved. I was a little bit involved. I was calling him to salah, and we prayed in the masjid. I said, I want to learn a bit. I was a Catholic, so I had a perception of Jesus Christ, Isa alayhi salam, has some sort of a divine, all these things I had, is one of the Trinity, one of the part of it, or one of the three members. So I had sort of a knowledge about, because I was brought up in Catholicism. So I asked this brother about what is Jesus? Who is this? What do you believe? And then he told a bit about what the Quran has to say about Isa alayhi salam, Jesus peace be upon him. And he was introducing me step by step to the religion. He was giving a bit of dawah, and he was going through the Quran and reading and all these things about the verses in the Quran. And okay, and he gave me a Quran as well to keep in my room. And I was reading it when I get free time. But I didn't have no knowledge about who is the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I didn't have any knowledge. Alhamdulillah, then eventually we have to depart because the doctor said, okay, you are fine now, you are good to go. You take your medication, take your all of the stuff, and they discharge me. Alhamdulillah, men, Nottingham Islam brothers, I met them at the Dawa table, which they do in Hyson Green and City Center. I met them, and I was one of the brother questioned me, posed a question, why? What's your religion at the moment? I said, I'm Christian. I'm Muslim. This was my answer. He said, Allah, you can't be. You have to choose here. You have to. You can't. If you be a Muslim, you can't be a Christian. You have to come out. You have to be a Muslim, or you have. We can prove that Islam is the truth. And he was arguing, I was posing questions, I was posing my doubts, my concerns, my misconceptions about Islam to the brother. And the brothers were trying to give me answers to my questions and all these things. So I met them once in a while and regularly posing questions, posing my doubts to them. And alhamdulillah, because Islam has the answers for all the questions, alhamdulillah, and they were providing me with the necessary answers and feedbacks, alhamdulillah. So I learned about it, and with the knowledge which I have, a minimum knowledge about Islam, the basic knowledge, and what fascinated me is the tawhid, the oneness, worshipping the Creator alone, submitting to Him. Islam means the submission to the one and only Almighty God, and we don't associate any partners, any mediators to worship Him like the other religions which do. So this really amazed me. I thought, alhamdulillah, because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that natural fitra, inclination, we have the inclination to worship the one God. So if obviously it's a revert, the term we use is a revert, because we come back to the religion. So alhamdulillah, this really, really fit the suited my fitra, and I was saying the oneness of the Creator, worship Him alone, don't associate partners, and all of them Jesus. They explained about the Jesus was a messenger of God, and He's a mighty messenger, and we believe in Him, and we believe in His miracles and all these things. And then Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the final prophet, and to him was revealed the Quran. Alhamdulillah, then I was reading the Quran after 1 year, well, knowing about Islam, and I thoroughly knew that Islam is the truth. I'm going to submit myself to the Creator Almighty God and follow the commandments of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. And alhamdulillah, I went to the I realized that the Shahada, about the Shahada, and I realized that I wasn't aware of the Shahada when I did it first time at the hospital. So I met the brothers. I said, I'm going to make the Shahada again in front of the Nottingham Islam brothers and all the other reverts. I said the Shahada, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah and Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Alhamdulillah. But I want to dedicate my life to propagate Islam, or to the development of Islam, and to give the Islam to the world, which many people don't know about it. They have the view of the misconceptions, and they hold these negative views, and they should be educated. The Islam should be propagated and be told what we follow, the Quran and the Sunnah, so that the people may adhere, listen. They will come to know, realize that there is a Creator, and we should follow, obey this Creator. And since I came out, had an history of mental health, before nearly 2 years after being a Muslim, still I had encountered this depression, anxiety, and all these things. So I knew that Islam can provide me solution. Islam had the solution, but I was still reaching out to it, still learning and going in the process. I was improving, and alhamdulillah, and as far as still I'm a Muslim who is learning the deen, and Islam is helping me in all aspects, learning, in providing solutions, and even any problems as a new Muslim. Because the problem is, Muslims are revert, most of them come into the truth, to realize that Islam is the truth, and even when they accept Islam, they might not be getting a chance to know the commandments, to know the code of conduct, and to implement it. So Nottingham Islam is doing a big role to get the Muslims out there, new Muslims, and to make them practice, make them implement Islam, so that we have a peace in this world, and inshallah we look forward for attaining the pleasure of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, and attain Jannatul Firdausala Allah. Amen.